Hello, dear colleagues. My name is Alexey Koshevnik, and together with Yuri Vesnevsky, today I would like to present you some speech related to the driver monitoring systems, which is developed together in scope of collaboration between St. Petersburg Federal Research Center of the Russian Academy of Science and SCOUND company. Firstly, I would like to say about win-win collaboration with our between our organization. We started in October 2019 and signed the license agreement to distribute the software which was developed before related to the driver monitoring. And after that, we had different contracts related to the consulting and development contracts. And at the moment, we have two pilot projects, which is related to the show to the real customers how the driver monitoring can work and what the benefits they can get from such system. The table of contents of our presentation will include some motivational aspects. We say why the driver monitoring is needed. After that, I will say a little bit about the introduction and say about our system, how it looks like. After that, we consider the how the danger state detection is working in our system. And also how the driving data analysis is implemented. After that, we say about the solution prototypes and say a little bit about the business perspectives and some conclusions at the end. Okay, if we say about the motivation, we analyzed the road police statistics, National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, and road accident and safety statistics. And we can conclude that 94% of accidents occurs due to the driver, because the driver is the reason of 94% of the accidents. It's really high. And so, if we say about the driver concentration, it's about 20% of accidents occurs due to the driver concentration reducing. Yeah. And it's about 6% it's related to the drowsiness, and 14% it's related to the distraction dangerous states. And 74% of accidents occurs due to the traffic rules violations. It's related to the speeding, aggressive driving, traffic priority violation, and etc. etc. But 20% is really high percent. And if we say about the accidents, yeah, you can see in the picture that it's accident and what it can be in this picture. And since the driver did not look to the road, and maybe he or she slept. And if we say about the driver monitoring, sometimes the system can alert the driver and predict some situations. We can say the real photo from the real situation in the car. Yeah, you can see that at the moment the driver looking to the phone. He is not looking to the road really. He smoke. The belt is unfastened because it's dangerous. Yeah. And what it can be done in this case? Yeah. And from our point of view, we should understand such situation automatically and alert the dispatcher that the driver has a dangerous behavior. And now, at the moment, yeah, last years, we have a lot of initiations, yeah, in European Union and in Russia. And in European Union, they would like to make the speed limiters, driver monitors mandatory for the all new buying cars. Yeah. And if you say about Russian, we can a lot of initiatives from the taxi companies, for example, Yandex Taxi, say that they would like to monitor the drivers to prevent the sleeping, to prevent the drowsiness, dangerous states. Yeah. And how does it look? We propose our driver monitoring system that consists of camera, computational module, speaker, and GPS sensor. And the system is able to monitor the driver. You can see in the picture, the camera looks to the driver. And our system provides possibilities to say about the distraction, dangerous state, drowsiness, dangerous state, belt unfastened, smoking in the cabin, yeah, smartphone usage, eating or drinking, or some camera problem. For example, the driver would like to close the camera by hand or by some additional device. In this case, sure, this situation should be monitored. And also our system can be run by smartphone or, as you can see in the picture, in the device based on NVIDIA Jetson Nano. Sure, the smartphone is like more cheaper for the driver because usually the driver has a smartphone, yeah? And for example, for testing purposes or something like this, it's a more convenient way. But if you say about the situation with the fleet, yeah, if you say about the fleet management, sure that special device is better because the device can be mounted in the vehicle and it cannot be unmounted by the driver. And in this case, it's more reasonable if you would like to monitor for the driver because the driver sometimes wouldn't like to be monitored. How our system looks like? We have in the vehicle, we have the driver monitoring system, which consists of the camera-based monitoring, sensor data analysis. And based on these sensors, we predict the danger states and recommend some recommendations to the driver. For example, yeah, we can say about the okay, you are drowsy, and in this case, it's reasonable to take two cups of coffee, for example, yeah, at the nearest gas station. And if you say about the dangerous state, yeah, sure, we should analyze the sensor data because, for example, if the driver looks to the right, but in case if he stays in the cross and waiting the green signal, in this case, it's okay, it's completely okay. But in case he speed about 40 kilometers per hour or 60 kilometers per hour, it's not possible to see to the right more than, for example, 2 or 3 seconds. Yeah? And all these statistics are provided to the cloud. And in the cloud, we have the database with the driver monitoring statistics. And we generate the trip reports for the statistic consumers and can be dispatchers from the car sharing companies, taxi companies, logistics companies, or some insurance companies. Yeah? And we have some special personalization modules, which allows us to personalize our dangerous state detection to the particular driver. And we identify some driver behavior patterns. If you say about the driving context, because it's a really, really important situation, because we should understand when we provide some recommendations or when we detect the dangerous situation, what is the context, yeah? And for example, here we consider the understanding, is it a city driving or a highway driving? And here you can see the driver road and it can be labeled. Yeah, by blue, we can see the city driving, and green, it's like a highway driving. And you can see that really in Vasilevsk Island, we have a blue road. It's related to the city driving, because it's like a small speed. But green one, it's a high speed road. It's like a special high speed road from the St. Petersburg Vasilievsky Island to the circle road around the city and some part of the circle road. In this case, you can see that the system is completely right to predict this driving context situation. And how we detect the dangerous state? We detected dangerous state and we use the raw data. And for the raw data, it's sure the firstly it's like a camera frame, it's angle, gyroscope angle, it's like a direction based on magnetometer, it's location, accelerometer, lightness level, and like some audio fragment from microphone. And based on this raw data, we calculate the calculated parameters for single frame. And for the single frame, we have like a forehead color, and based on this situation, we predict the heart rate. Yeah, we have eyes openness for the one frame. We have the head yaw angle, head pitch angle, mouth openness, vehicle position, speed, lightness condition, speed rate, and speech loudness. And based on such information from single frame, we calculate the visual cues. And visual cues, it's like a sequence of frame. And based on this information, we calculate some pattern, yeah, based on the sequence frame. For example, percentage of eyes closure is parameter that is base parameter for drowsiness detection. Or, for example, yawning. You can understand that driver is yawning because in the sequence of frame, the mouth is opened. Yeah. And, for example, head movement. Yeah. Because, for example, if the driver looks to the mirror and return his or her head to the road, it's completely okay. But in case the driver looked to the right more than, for example, 4 seconds, yeah, in this case, we should understand that it's distraction dangerous state. And sure, in every case, we should understand the vehicle maneuvers, yeah, because based on these maneuvers, it's related to the distraction detection and drowsiness detection. For example, when the driver stops to the cross, for example, he can close his eyes. It's completely okay. It's not a drowsiness, yeah, because, for example, he's a little bit tired and close his eyes. Yeah. And dangerous states, we are dividing to the online detected dangerous states and offline detected dangerous states. For online detected, we say about like a camera problem, seatbelt fastness detection, smoking, smartphone usage, eating or drinking, and also drowsiness using the image analysis, distraction, and drowsiness using the speed analysis. And for offline detecting dangerous states, we say about the high heart rate, like drunk driving, aggressive driving, and stress condition. And offline detected dangerous states are dangerous states which we detect in the cloud and also provide offline information about this situation, maybe to the driver, maybe to the dispatchers based on the case. And sure, we say about the effects we have from the dangerous states. Yeah, sure, it can be the traffic accidents, it's like interference to the another drivers, it can be road damage, and sure, non-eco-friendly driving, which is really popular in Europe and USA. And if we say about the distraction dangerous state, we understand that we should detect the like a base angle, based angle of view of the driver, because we cannot put the camera in the front view. We need to move the camera to the right, a little bit to the right or a little bit to the left, and usually we locate the camera around the back mirror. And in this case, we have an angle between the camera and the straight view of the driver. And we should detect this angle. This angle can be as yaw as well as pitch. And we propose the automatic head angles calibration. And we propose this algorithm. And we understand that if we use the algorithm in the speed more than 30 kilometers per hour, and if we use it about 50 seconds, we can understand the angle with precision more than 70%. And for example, if we monitor the driver about 10 minutes, we have accuracy about 99%. But for 70% is completely okay, and in this case, less than 50 seconds we really need. And in the real system at the moment, we use the 30 seconds, and we have a really, really high accuracy. The dangerous trend prediction model, I say about like a belt prediction, cell phone prediction, eating, drinking, and smoking prediction is based on the YOLO TINI version 3 model. Here you can see the architecture of the model. And the main idea that we collected the data set of the drivers inside the vehicle, and also we taken some data sets from the internet, and we train the neural network using the YOLO based on our data set that that was manually labeled. We label the belt, we label the smartphone, we label the some cigarettes, and we label some bottles of drinking or some hamburgers and bananas, and we train on this data the neural network, and after that we evaluate it in the public roads. Yeah, as well as they evaluate using the special training dataset. When we say about the distraction detection, dangerous state, we propose the following algorithm. Firstly, for the driver head angle detection, we use a 3D DFA model, and based on this algorithm, it can be read in our paper how the 3D DFA model is used. And based on this model, we use the following algorithm. We understand the we take the face image frame. Yeah. In some cases, we can skip the frame. For example, if we understand that we have a really, really high lighting conditions or something like this, we can skip the frame without a consideration. And after that, we understand if the face is detected, and we detect the facial landmarks or angle, yeah, using the 3D DFA model, and put this information to the event buffer. And after that, we understand if we have enough events in the event buffer, we can understand the driver is distracted. Yeah, and in event buffer, usually we it's related to the speed also. And for example, we have some situation, like for example, if the driver driving speed is less than 20 kilometers per hour, in this case, we say about 4 seconds in event buffer. If we say about more than 80 kilometers per hour, we say about 2 seconds, because if the speed is higher, in this case, we need to understand distraction in a more quick way. And we have the situation with drowsiness, it's also with a buffer. And in this case, also we understand the frame, and we understand if the eyes are opened or not. And based on this information about the eyes and about the mouth, we understand the drowsiness danger state, or we understand the yawning danger state. And also we use the buffer, and we calculate the amount of frames when the driver is closed his or her eyes or is yawns. And based on this information, we say about the drawsets. We have developed our own drawsiness detection model. This model is based on efficient net v0 architecture, and we classified the following states. Yeah, the eyes is opened or eyes is closed, or we have a sunglasses, and the driver looks direct or the driver looks down. The main idea that firstly we had the model that classifies the opened or closed eyes. But after that, we understand that, for example, if you have like a black sunglasses, the eyes are invisible, and we have a better accuracy in this case of our model. And in this case, we add additional state that driver has a sunglasses. And also another situation, we have some cases when the driver looks to the down. It's, for example, for some smartphone located to the down, or maybe media system, and it's very likely that the driver closed his eyes. And we also try to understand using the neural network, it's looking to the down, or is it a real closing his or her eyes. And really it works fine. And also we have a drowsiness detection using the speed analysis. And we try to understand, is it possible or not to find the data set to understand the drowsiness by speed analysis. And we understand that at the moment there are no such data set. And we collected the data set, and our data set includes about 400 minutes. Yeah. We have rides with the different cars, and the speed measurements was recorded using our drive safely system, like our driver monitoring system, using Android-based smartphone. And what we have done? Yeah, we have compared the different classification model. It was a decision trees, logistic regression, Gaussian native bias, gradient boosting on decision trees, and we compared with neural network using the precision recall F1 accuracy and Rokawuk score, and we have the following results. Also, we have tried to identify the aggressive driving using the adaptive thresholds. And here you can see that aggressive driving is very, it's very related to the driving and very related to the situation. Because you can understand, for example, the different cars, yeah, and different cars, they have different engines, yeah. And if we have a BMW, it's like last model, and in this case, if we compare with like a Kia Rio car, for example, if the driver drives the BMW and he is not aggressive, but his acceleration will be more than, for example, aggressive driving at Kia Rio, because the engine is completely different. And in this case, we say that we should have, in this case, like adaptive thresholds, yeah, and we should understand what's the usual situation, what's the usual acceleration of the X and Y axis of the driver, and what's the current one. And we compare the current one with the usual one. And in this case, we can understand, is it a real aggressive situation or it's a usual situation for the driver. How it looks like? Here you can see the system run in a smartphone, and you can see like a usual navigation system, and this navigation system is run together with our software, driver monitoring software. And you can see in the screen that the smartphone detects the drowsiness danger state, because as you can see, the driver closed his eyes. Yeah, and in this case, situation is recognized, and we have a special alert, and we have a special voice alert. How does it look like in reality in the vehicle?
Drowsiness state is detected.
It was a drowsiness dangerous state.
Driver, do not fall asleep while driving.
The system generates the visualizations. And here you can see the right car.
Driver, do not be distracted from road. Do you confirm dangerous state?
The system says about dangerous state.
Accepted.
So here you can see the training mode. Then the system asks the driver, is it a real situation or not? And the driver said yes. And in this case, the system can train for further analysis. For example, if the driver say no, we can understand that this is not a distraction for this particular driver. How the interface looks like? Here you can see the dispatcher interface. Yeah, it's like a trip start, trip end. Yeah, and you can see the map. And in this map, you can see like pictograms, and it's like a phone usage, it's like a drowsiness, it's distraction. And also at the left side, it's possible to see the video. And we record the video 10 seconds before dangerous state and 10 seconds after dangerous state. And using this video, it's possible to see is it a real dangerous state or, for example, mistake of the system. And in this case, based on these videos, we had a possibility to evaluate our system. And if you say about the mobile application, we have more than 10,000 downloads in Google Play, and we have really a lot of countries, the people download our application and try to use it in the roads. If you say about NVIDIA Jetson Nano system, it consists of the main computational block based on the NVIDIA Jetson Nano device. And also we added a sound card, we added an emergency accumulator, we added the power supply model, we added the 4G modem and the GPS model. And at the right picture, you can see how it looks like. If you say about the business perspectives of who can be a particular customers. At the moment, the Scout company has a lot of customers, you can see in the screen, that are work with the Scout based on the vehicle monitoring using the GPS sensors. And during the conferences where some situation discussed related to is the driver monitoring is reasonable or not, the representatives of this company say that it's really reasonable, and they think that implementation of such systems to the vehicles can significantly decrease the amount of accidents. Okay, thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, please go to the Zoom section and ask your questions. I would like to ask you, and also Yurii Nevesnesky also will help me. And for the conclusion, I would like to say that now we have a technology, and we evaluate our technology, and the accuracy is really high. But it's not very reasonable to say about the numbers, yeah, because the accuracy is really related to the lighting conditions. Because, for example, yeah, if you have a smartphone and if they have a night condition, in this case, accuracy will be slow because the smartphone do not have the infrared camera. But, for example, in this case, the Jetson Nano device is better in the night time, and accuracy is really high. But if you say about the day situation, and in case of sun, we have like some blinks. And in this case, it can be a problem. Because, for example, sometimes the sun can make some figures in the jacket, and sometimes, for example, if the belt is unfastened, yeah, but sometimes the sun can draw some figures in the jacket, and this figure is looks like the belt, for example, or looks like a smartphone, or looks like a something like this. And in this case, sure, we have the wrong detections, or for example, we can miss some situation. But in any case, I think this is a future. This technology is a future in our cars, and in few years, we will have some technologies which will be installed in the vehicles, which can be bought in the shops, in the vehicle shops. Yeah. And in this case, it's before we have like a fully automated vehicles. This is our future, because sure, we will have the fully automated vehicles, but seems we will not have it in the nearest future. Yeah, we will have it maybe in 20 years, but not in 1 year, not in 2 years. Yeah, and in this case, the driver monitoring is really mandatory and really needed option for the our nearest future. Okay, and drive safely and be safety in the road. Thank you. Bye.